Dino, what's going on?
Just doing that company cybersecurity training. Stuff's so obvious and so boring. I just kind of want to wrap it up.
I agree. I just clicked through mine as fast as I could to get it done.
That's not a bad idea.
Hey, did you catch that Pens game last night?
I did. I was just going to talk to you about that. How about that overtime goal, huh?
Man, that was something else, man. I tell you what, I love me some Pens.
Yeah, the only thing, Pens. I could have swore that one play was...
All right, I'm done here.
Dude.
Huh, what's that? 512 gigabytes. Don't mind if I do.
Good morning.
Hey, good morning, Santino.
Hey, I just found this flash drive out in the parking lot. Do you want to see what's on it?
Sure, let's do it. I didn't save my work, Santino.
Oh, I'm sorry. It must be. Exit out. What's it doing?
I don't know.
What is it doing?
I don't know.
Come on, exit.
I don't know.
Quit it out. So where did I go wrong? Had I paid attention to my cybersecurity training, I would have known not to use random flash drives that seem harmless on company computers. These are a common method for hackers to gain access to their targets. An attack of this nature could compromise valuable and sensitive company information and could also leave the network vulnerable to future attacks. Cybercrime data breaches cost businesses $1 trillion in 2018 and are set to double to $2 trillion in 2019. The cyber threat is growing as businesses continue to add devices to the internet and compile sensitive data in data centers. The cost is projected to be $6 trillion by 2021. This cost doesn't even include the money companies spend trying to prevent the breaches in the first place. The average cost of a single data breach is $3.68 million. 95% of cybersecurity breaches are actually caused by human error, like the example we just saw with the flash drive. One other issue is that 38% of all malicious files have very well-known Microsoft Office file extensions, such as Word, PowerPoint, and Excel. Cyber attacks can occur by other means, of course. For example, an internet attack occurs about every 39 seconds. We typically think of a cyber attack as coming in on only the digital network. The power network can also be hacked, in a sense, to cause damage to power equipment, which can in turn cause digital network outages. Take this 120-volt outlet bug, for example. The malicious actor can simply walk by a standard wall outlet and plug in a device that is designed to affect a nearby and critical power component. This chattering or fast switching of the power could damage nearby lighting or even destroy motor drives in a nearby motor control center. It could also trip relays and cause power outages in a nearby data center. With the advent of smart grids, we are adding new interconnected devices to enhance our control capabilities. This brings new risk because each device adds a potential node of attack for cyber criminals. Dozens of power grids in the US and elsewhere are already being probed by dangerous hacking organizations. Hackers probe the network for potential weak points and use this information to stage a full-scale attack if and when the time is right. These attacks have physical ramifications and can also be fatal to facility personnel, not to mention the civil unrest that would be caused by a massive power outage. As cyber attacks are on the rise, companies need to stay vigilant and mitigate the risks of the digital age. Eaton is combating these threats with what we call the Secure Development Lifecycle. This is a 7-step development process that establishes guidelines for all of Eaton's products development teams to deliver a safe, secure, and reliable product. The cycle starts with developers undergoing specific security training for threat modeling, security requirements, and secure code testing. Next comes the review and design, where the product undergoes threat modeling and security requirement analysis. This is followed by implementation, where the product goes through a battery of automated test suites to identify weaknesses as early as possible. The verification stage continues with manual penetration testing for weaknesses that may have been missed by the automated software testing. Before approval for release, the product must have a vulnerability mitigation update patch strategy defined by the developers. The lifecycle continues with incident response, where the previously developed strategy is executed when necessary and customers are updated on potential vulnerabilities and patches are released to fix them. The secure development lifecycle spans the life of a device from its inception, deployment, and maintenance phases. To talk more about Eaton Cybersecurity, let me introduce Matt Adams, one of our leading cybersecurity engineers.
Thanks, Santino. The Product Cybersecurity Center of Excellence at Eaton works closely with Eaton product teams to design products with cybersecurity protocols and best practices in mind. Cybersecurity is in our DNA, and it starts with our employees, who all take cybersecurity awareness training. We deploy Eaton's secure development lifecycle process, which integrates security protocols at every phase of product development and production right through product lifecycle. Our approach is based on our proven experience as well as various external standards, regulations, and frameworks that come from organizations including UL, IEC, NIST, and SAE. Eaton Cybersecurity Lab is the first lab approved to participate in UL's Data Acceptance Program for cybersecurity. The lab has the capability to test Eaton products with intelligence or embedded logic to key aspects of the UL 2900 standard. We are focused on releasing products that are secure by design, secure by default, and secure in deployment to help our customers create trusted applications.
You can rely on Eaton for the latest connected network thinking, best practices, and advanced technologies needed to address cybersecurity risk. For more about cybersecurity, head to eaton.com/cybersecurity. Contact your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center, where we have the cybersecurity demos you saw in the video today, and much more on Power Systems.